So today we are going to talk about PS5's new DualSense controller, and this is of course not a channel where we cover console related content, but the focus for this video is going to be how well the PS5 controller works with Windows games and how you can enable the special haptic features on it with them. Hey guys, I am Siddharth and let's talk about all of that. So first, I would just go over my thoughts on the controller itself. It is definitely one of the best, if not the best looking controller on the market. The position of share and menu button is better on the new controller. I like the new clear plastic buttons, and the touchpad is now also really well integrated. The trigger and shoulder buttons are also bigger and they feel slightly nicer, but the analog sticks and the actual feel of the D-pad and the primary buttons feels identical. But that isn't a bad thing, as the DualShock 4 was already so refined with its 2-decade-old design. All of these improvements are nice to have, but it's not as big of a jump as it may look like over the PS4 controller. But the highlight feature of the DualSense controller is of course the special haptics it has, along with its special triggers which can vary in resistance to emulate what is happening in your games. But when you are using this with Windows, these special features are of course not going to work, because first of all, the PS5 controller is not natively supported in Windows games, and Windows games also don't have the code for telling the controller how to vibrate or how to control its triggers. Now, unless these games get native support for these features, the trigger resistance features are just not going to work, but the haptics on the PS5 controller work in a very interesting way, and we can actually make them work with Windows games. But first, we will discuss how to make the DualSense controller work with any game on Windows. And to do that, you just have to connect the controller to PC by pressing and holding the PlayStation button and the share button until you see its blue light blinking twice. Then you have to go to Bluetooth setting on your PC and add the controller as a device. You can also use a Type A to Type C cable to connect it if you don't have Bluetooth on your PC. Then you have to download the DS4 Windows software from the link in the video description, and after you install it and set up its drivers, this will emulate an Xbox 360 controller on Windows. So basically, Windows will think that you have connected an Xbox 360 controller, and so it will work on all games that support the 360 controller. The DS4 Windows also has many other features that let you control how your DualSense controller works. You can customize the LED color, and you can even set the controller to work as a mouse and keyboard on your PC, as you can configure the touchpad to behave like a laptop touchpad for controlling your mouse, and you can assign any mouse or keyboard buttons to any of the buttons on the DualSense. And you can even use the gyro sensor on the controller to control your mouse, and this actually even works in driving games, and you can turn this into an air steering, which is a really fun thing to explore. The vibration on the controller also works with this method, but it is just a very basic rumble instead of the advanced haptics we have on this controller. So now I will tell you how to make the haptics work on this controller, but before that, we have to understand how the DualSense controller handles its haptics, and a part of that is by directly linking the audio output to vibration motors. So basically, if you can feed audio input to the controller, you can make the vibration motors work, and to do that, you will have to connect the controller to your PC with USB, because that is the only way you can output audio to it. When you plug in the DualSense controller to your PC with USB, it basically shows up as a 4-channel audio device in Windows, and two of these speakers are for your regular stereo audio through the 3.5mm audio out jack we have on the controller, but the two other channels which are generally used for surround sound are the channels that control the vibration motors, so we just have to duplicate the audio output to these channels. To do that, you first have to select the wireless controller as your Windows audio output. Then you have to open the sound control panel by right-clicking on the speaker icon on Windows and selecting sounds. Then you have to go to the speaker properties of the controller in the playback tab, go to the enhancement tab, select speaker fill and click on OK. This option duplicates the audio input to other two channels which control the vibration motors. So now you just have to plug in your headphones or your speakers to the 3.5mm jack of the controller, and you can enjoy your games with the haptic feedback, as the sound frequencies will make the controller rumble in a very nice way. But the problem with this method is that you will have to use the audio output from your controller, and you may not even have speakers that you can directly plug into your controller. So to get the sound output from your computer to its speakers while also getting the haptic vibration on your controller, you will have to send sound signals to the controller and to your computer's sound chip at the same time. And to do that, you will have to download an application called Voice Meter from the link in the video description. After installing it, you have to launch it. then go to its hardware out section. Then in the A1 output, you have to select wireless controller with WDM driver, but if this doesn't work, you can select the MME driver for the controller. Then in the second output, you have to select your audio device, and this should be a Realtek chip for most motherboards, which could be named high definition audio device. So you have to select this, or if you have an external DAC like me, you have to select that. You also have to select the stereo repeat option here, and this will do the same thing that the speaker fill option did in the Windows control panel. If you are using DS4 Windows, you have to go to Settings tab when the controller is connected, click on Device option, select the DualSense controller, and disable the Enable Rumble Emulation option, otherwise the haptics are not going to work. So with this method, you will be able to get sound on your regular speakers, and you will also get haptic feedback on your controller. Now this is still not as good as what you would get with native haptic support on PS5 games, but it still works well enough. And even though it just turns sounds into vibrations, it can feel pretty cool because the vibrations are quite refined and they even work for the higher frequencies of sounds. You can also control the intensity of these haptics by adjusting the gain or volume on your PC and then controlling the volume on your speaker separately by using their inbuilt controls. Do give this video a thumbs up if you've been enjoying it so far, and also subscribe with bell so you don't miss out on future videos. Now games like Rocket League do support the DualSense controller natively, so it is possible that we may see advanced haptics and trigger support for DualSense by some games, but I am not sure if developers are really going to do that, so I wouldn't count on them for this. So that was not a short process, but it is good to see that we can kind of get the haptics working on PC. It does feel pretty cool in driving games, and you do get some feel for the road textures. Other than this, there isn't a significant difference between the PS4 and PS5 controller, so if you want to save some money, you can just go with the PS4 controller. I would also like to give a shout out to this Reddit user whose post contributed to some content of this video. So I'll have links to buy this controller along with the software I mentioned in the video description. Let me know if this worked for you in the comment section below. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell, follow me on socials, check out my Amazon store. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.